Repulsing rings, count your inches, repulsing grace. Look, we've got sponsors!
Yay!
Stan has given us a $120 gift voucher to give away.
Thanks, Stan. Stan. So we've got two to give away every single episode until the end of the season. $120 worth.
It's more than what they earn on Drag Race UK.
All right,
snap, snap. We've got a job to do. We've got sponsors.
Gonna have to be professional now.
No.
Welcome back to Mini Cooper and DJ Dan Murphy's recap, reaction, review.
I love recap. I love a recap.
That's good.
I like that.
Oh, thanks. That's quite clever.
Everyone's
been saying it for a few years.
Oh, I've never heard that before. There's a lot of things about that. We walked into the workroom after who was eliminated last week. Then we have them discussing, you know, Blue Hyde Granger. It was nice to see a young queen having performance experience.
She said she performs four nights a week, so.
Unlike the other two.
Never performed before, ever. Ever!
Like,
ever!
Great first kick, love that one.
Oh, I still can't get over that, anyway.
Worthy, you've moved on a bit. There were a few things, though.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Well, you know, I write notes too this week.
What did you think of the actual mini challenge dancing around the maypole?
I really enjoyed it, but my best, even before the challenge, sorry to backtrack a little bit. But here, let me, I'm trying to find out who it is actually.
Here we go.
Who was it?
She takes notes 1 week and all of a sudden we're backtracking.
I know, we guys shouldn't have taken notes. Yeah, I'm happy I could have done it.
You nearly slapped me. You're about to slap me.
No.
I just remember watching that mini challenge like this.
What is going on?
What's happening? Why are they doing this? So yeah, I put in my notes, I felt sad for Cheryl, but I can't remember why. Last episode, I was really, oh. This episode, I tried to put all that aside and just take it for what it was, and I kind of liked it this episode.
Yeah, I must admit, I did too. I did. Yeah. She's like on a simmer. I wouldn't say she's cooked yet, but she's simmering.
She's simmering.
I did love her in the when they got to the challenge, the maypole challenge.
Yeah.
The restaurant. Who'd have thought? I never would have guessed she would have done that. Never would have seen that coming. Did you?
Twice.
Done. I did like Miss Vivian's her pink bit flapping under the dress.
Oh, you know when they went off to get ready for the mini challenge?
Yes.
Did Vivian tear her eyebrows off? Are they fake eyebrows?
Did you really tear it? I didn't see that.
I don't know. I should have watched it again, but it looked like she went, all right, here we go.
I'd believe they'd be fake, because who would draw on eyebrows like that? You'd have to stick them on, wouldn't you? Actually, but she's much quite handsome.
Oh,
did you think? Okay. Think about it. I'm strangely good.
There's nobody there that you're like, oh, as a boy, and then pretty as a girl. There are a few that are like, okay, as a boy, and then, oh, as a girl.
Love Raven coming in. I love to say you look good, but I'd be lying.
I love when Raven comes in and something Wong goes, oh my God, Raven is here, and I'm the worst I've ever looked. I actually thought she looked pretty good for her. Not too bad.
Yeah, I agree, actually. They don't really dress up for the workroom, do they?
No. They'll learn that for season two.
Yeah.
All-Stars. You know when they come back for All-Stars and their every look in the workroom is polished?
Do you think that will happen in the UK? No, that would be the answer. Is that your thinking noise?
I love how surprised everybody is when Rue comes through the door. It's like a horror film. Like, she comes in and goes, hello, hello, hello. And everyone's like, ah! Oh, hello. Big smiles. Ah, don't send me home.
Did she spoke to Davina?
Good on you.
We thought exactly what we thought. She's a great actress. It's funny when you're in a competition, you get inside your head and you start doubting yourself instead of focusing on actually what you're doing.
I love how the first question Rue asked when she chats to Davina is, you got emotional last week on the runway. Talk to me about that.
It's not therapy.
Ugh. Yeah, she seemed fine this week. What I've noticed though, when you watch the episode back, keep an eye on Davina. She doesn't really talk much. Other queens don't really talk to her either.
She's on her own, she's a loner,
yeah,
isn't she?
Yeah. When they all come together after the runway, I'm jumping ahead, but you watch, if she's sitting there, you can tell she's the winner and everybody's talking about themselves or other people and she's just sitting there like this.
Do you think they're threatened by it?
Now that she's won, I think they'll be threatened.
Well, there's that moment where there's Bagger, who's the actor, Miss Vivian, who's the look queen, and Crystal, who doesn't know what she is.
She's good at being hairy.
You love her.
I liked it better this episode.
Yeah.
I tried to put all the things aside from the previous episodes, I'm still talking, and the hair didn't bother me quite so much this time, and Cheryl was okay. All right, you can talk now.
No, it was all about the hair and why he loves the gent. at all. Oh. Did you like it? Oh, you, do you know what? I knew you were going to eye roll.
I've got to hear it.
Yeah, I know. When Crystal said that, I could see Dan go like this.
Like this with my nose. Gender. She goes, I like messing with people's minds. It's like, you're not messing with me. You're annoying me. Just be good.
Well, she was.
Oh, yeah, she was pretty good.
And what about video strokes trying to make an outfit? Very confused. Like how she was like a pumpkin at one point. When did she think that looked good? And what else did we discover? She doesn't make her own drag. She pays for that bad shit. She paid for that. You were ripped off, Dale. You've been ripped off. She paid for that bad drag. She paid for that. Sweet, she said that. When they were sitting around discussing the sewing. Do you know what? I didn't sew. I paid for my drag. Oh, what? You didn't make that crap. You paid for it.
I'm gonna have an asthma attack.
But it's just true.
Oh, I got a stitch.
So when they were sitting around talking, she said that I was like, you paid. Something wrong. What surprised me about her, doing something she's never done before, where she can actually do other things on a major challenge. Why would you do that? I don't understand the logic in that.
And she was warned by the Vivian and by RuPaul.
Yeah.
And did it anyway. I did love that Michelle said there have been 500 seasons of this show. You need to know how to sew. It's not a surprise when you get there that you've got to sew an outfit. Learn the basics.
If you can't sew, have an eye for design. So you could take stuff and just hot glue stuff together and make it look good. Like you don't necessarily have to sew for a challenge like that either. It's about design. If you can design rubbish, you achieve something. But I have to say, I didn't hate her outfit when she came out though. I thought it was okay, considering what I thought it was gonna be.
She was holding it together at the front. If she went like this, it went.
A bag of chips having pubic hair. And she actually came out looking like, you know, this would be her house, I reckon. You know when hair gets all caught in the sink and it gets stuck? She came out as that, as her outfit. Can you see that? Bag of pits.
Especially from behind when she turned around and walked to the back of the stage. Oh, it was like, oh.
It was basically walking pits.
So bag of chips, I thought her outfit, it was rough, but she was still fun. Her personality overpowers any.
She's just got charm, doesn't she?
Yeah.
She could come out as a turd and still get through it. She came out as Liza Minnelli, came out as pubic hair, safe. That is talent. I have to say, I was shocked she wasn't in the bottom, but then I saw the others and I'm like, oh God. What about Cheryl? That was quite funny.
I love Cheryl's outfit. I love that. Anything that's kind of repeated, like where you use using five fingers, you use 500 fingers. I just love that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I actually didn't hate her outfit as much as I thought.
But what about in the workroom when something wrong's talking to Vinegar and she's like, oh, babes, if you go home, I'm gonna really miss you. Basically saying, you're going home and I'm gonna miss you.
Actually, no, it was Miss, wasn't it? No, it wasn't Miss Vivian, it was Vinegar Strokes. And
that's what I said.
Oh. I'm not good with names.
Something Wong was basically saying, I'm gonna miss you when you leave, and started crying. Vinegar's like, I haven't left yet. I've still got the runway to go.
I love when RuPaul was in the workroom. Let's talk about your drag. Dare I say it's a bit hodgepodge. Not very glamazon. Oh, I thought, wow. That was an act of kindness, I thought.
Poor old Vinegar's like, to have the host of the show and it being RuPaul, the most famous drag queen in the world, no offense, say that to you, it was like, oh, dagger to the heart.
If RuPaul said that to you, then hence the book, read between the lines. Oh, that was funny, don't you think that was funny, the hodgepodge? And it's just the way RuPaul went. I'll say it with an English word, it sounds so much more pleasant when you say it in an English way. Right? That was it.
I would be like,
that was good.
Imagine being told that, you'd be like,
oh, you'd give up drag.
Or try harder, maybe?
Blue Hydrangea, she needed to get rid of the tinsel off her outfit. It ruined the outfit. Yeah, I think she like ran through the, you know how you have tinsel curtains at Christmas? She'd run through and got caught in it on the way to the runway. Wasn't actually part of the costume. Such a shame, because the rest of it was quite fabulous.
Yeah, she didn't look too bad.
I loved Davina's outfit, I just think.
Oh my God.
That was, dare I say it, candy bags that we call them here at Australia. She sprayed herself in spray glue, ran through the $2 shop, and looked fabulous.
It was such a good look.
Yeah, it was fantastic.
And everyone kept saying how hard it was to make that look out of that material.
Oh yeah, because it's like so stiff and it's got no, it's basically wearing meat. Stiff. Yeah, not good.
Thank you.
I really loved Crystal's outfit. It was with a pompadour skirt. It was quite whimsical, I thought. I thought it was really gorgeous.
Yeah, it was very her as well.
Yeah, and I love the headdress and all that. I thought that was really fantastic.
Even this section here with the hair, I wasn't jarred. I was okay with that.
Did we mention it?
And even Graham said the same thing. He's like, oh, normally I really don't like that hair, but today it was okay.
I think because it was with the shading as well. Now, I loved Miss Vivian's look with the cricket bat shoulders. Did you ever play cricket?
Take a look at me. Did I ever play cricket? Don't play it. Don't watch it. But I would wear it.
Yeah, I'd wear it great for a shoulder pad. And I love the reflection of the videotape on the runway. As a design, it was really fantastic.
Then vinegar came out. All I've got in my notes is, oh my God, what?
Do you know what? She was basically a shredding machine. I think it was a really good outfit. And the shoes, the pack of shoes, and the bodysuit. What has gone through her mind? I don't want to know, actually, because do you want to know?
I think it was written all over her.
They say you should never throw out books, but that one you'd have to, wouldn't you? She must be really nice, because I think Michelle was really upset. Did you not think so?
I didn't notice.
I know you, but I'm here to be a judge on a drag competition. Do you remember that?
In today's episode?
Yeah. Oh, you must have been looking gay.
How did I miss that part?
I did really like, I love Cheryl's energy on the runway. I love that she had the fragile thing there. It had a nice sense of humour about it, and I wouldn't expect her to be that clever. So, tip to you. Do you know what I find funny about the lip sync songs on RuPaul's Drag Race? Some young kid will come out and do Paula Abdul's Viability, and I think, how the hell did you know that song? Then I realise it's been on RuPaul's Drag Race.
And I just love the look on the judge's face while it's all happening. Twiggy's like this. What's going on?
We're all thinking the same thing, Twiggy. What's going on?
Well, it's prize time. We're going to give away with... So we've got... Jesus Christ, you can tell we've never had a sponsor before. We don't know what to do. So Stan has given us a $120 gift card and we've got two to give away every single episode. Just leave a comment on YouTube and you know how they don't have a prize this year for the winner because it's on BBC. I'll give away mine to whoever makes up the best non-prize and whatever I think is the funniest. Minnie?
Oh, that's really good.
I know.
Yeah. I just want to know your opinion of the show, but give me a funny quote about someone in the show and what you think of their drag in a funny kind of way. And I'll pick that as my favourite. Stan.
Stan. We love you, Stan. Stan, Stan, Stan.
Stan.
Stan. Oh, God.
I love that I've got a deeper voice than you.